This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The historiography of early Islam refers to the study of the early history of Islam during the 7th century, from Muhammad's first revelations in AD 610 until the disintegration of the Rashidun Caliphate in AD 661, and arguably throughout the 8th century and the duration of the Umayyad Caliphate, terminating in the incipient Islamic Golden Age around the beginning of the 9th century. Contents 1 Primary sources 11 7th century Islamic sources 12 7th century non-Islamic sources 13 Epigraphy 2 Traditional Muslim Historiography 21 Science of Biography, Science of Hadith, and Isnad 22 Historiography, Cultural History, and Philosophy of History 23 World History 24 Famous Muslim Historians 3 Modern Academic Scholarship 31 The Beginnings 32 Establishment of Academic Research 33 The Revisionist Challenge 4 Scholars Combining Traditional and Academic Scholarship 5 See also 6 References 7 Bibliography 8 External links Primary sources 7th century Islamic sources 692 Quranic Mosaic on the Dome of the Rock The Book of Sulaym ibn Qais, by Sulaym ibn Qasdeth, 7595-694-714 This is a collection of hadith and historical reports from the 1st century of the Islamic calendar Sulaym ibn Qais is the first Shia author in Al-Firist of Ibn al-Nadim also Al-Masudi refers to this book a manuscript of the book survived from the early 10th while it is the earliest available book of Shia Islam. Some Shia scholars are dubious about the authenticity of some part of it however the oldest known copy, on which the majority of modern manuscripts are based, was written in 1676 CE. 7th century non-Islamic sources There are numerous early references to Islam in non-Islamic sources Many have been collected in historiographer Robert G. Hoyland's compilation Seeing Islam as Others Saw It One of the first books to analyze these works was Hagarism authored by Michael Cook and Patricia Crone Hagarism contends that looking at the early non-Islamic sources provides a much different and more accurate picture of early Islamic history than the later Islamic sources do, although its thesis has little acceptance for some. The date of composition is controversial Some provide an account of early Islam which significantly contradicts the traditional Islamic accounts of 2 centuries later 634 Doctrina Jacobi 636 Fragment on the Arab Conquests 639 Sophronius, Patriarch of Jerusalem 640 Thomas the Presbyter 640 Homily on the Child Saints of Babylon 643-25 April per 558644 Coptic Apocalypse of Pseudo Shenut 648 Life of Gabriel of Cartman 650 Fredegar 655 Pope Martin I 659 Ishoiyab III of Adiabene 660 Sibos, Bishop of the Bagratunas 660 A Chronicler of Khuzestan 662 Maximus the Confessor 665 Benjamin I 670 Arkulf, a Pilgrim 676 The Synod of 676680 George of Rishina 680 The Secrets of Rabbi Simon ben Yohai 680 Bundahishkin 681 Trophies of Damascus 687 Athanasius of Balad, Patriarch of Antioch 687 John Bar Penke 690 Syriac Apocalypse of Pseudo-Methodius 692 Syriac Apocalypse of Pseudo-Ephraim 694 John of Nicaea 697 Anti-Jewish Polemicists. Epigraphy analysis of a sandstone inscription found in 2008, determined that it reads, In the name of Allah, I, Zuhair, wrote this at the time Umar died per year 4, and 20. It is worthwhile pointing out that Caliph Umar bin al-Khattab died on the last night of the month of Dhul-Hijjah of the year 23 AH, and was buried next day on the first day of Muharram of the new year 24 AH, corresponding to 644 CE thus the date mentioned in the inscription above conforms to the established and known date of the death of Umar bin al-Khattab Traditional Muslim historiography Further information, Muslim historiography Science of biography, Science of Hadith, and Isnad Further information, Science of Hadith hadith, hadith terminology, prophetic biography, and biographical evaluation. Muslim historical traditions first began developing from the earlier 7th century with the reconstruction of Muhammad's life following his death, because narratives regarding Muhammad and his companions came from various sources. It was necessary to verify which sources were more reliable in order to evaluate these sources. Various methodologies were developed, such as the science of biography, science of hadith, and Isnad chain of transmission. These methodologies were later applied to other historical figures in the Muslim world. Ilmr Rijal Arabic is the science of biography, especially as practiced in Islam, where it was first applied to the seerah, the life of the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad, and then the lives of the four rightly guided caliphs who expanded Islamic dominance rapidly since validating the sayings of Muhammad as a major study. Isnad, accurate biography, has always been of great interest to Muslim biographers, who accordingly attempted to sort out facts from accusations, bias from evidence, etc. The earliest surviving Islamic biography as Ibn Ishaq's Sirat Rasul Allah, written in the 8th century, but known to us only from later quotes and recensions 9th-10th century. The science of hadith is the process that Muslim scholars use to evaluate hadith. The classification of hadith into sahih sound, hasan good and da'if weak was firmly established by Ali ibn al-Madini 161-234 a.s. Later, al-Madini's student Muhammad al-Bukhari 810-870 authored a collection that he believed contained only sahih hadith, which is now known as the Sahih Bukhari. Al-Bukhari's historical methods of testing hadiths and isnads is seen as the beginning of the method of citation and a precursor to the scientific method which was developed by later Muslim scientists. I.A. Ahmad writes, "The vagueness of ancient historians about their sources stands in stark contrast to the insistence that scholars such as Bukhari and Muslim manifested in knowing every member in a chain of transmission and examining their reliability. They published their findings, which were then subjected to additional scrutiny by future scholars for consistency with each other and the Quran." Other famous Muslim historians who studied the science of biography or science of hadith included Urwa ibn Zubair, died 712, Wahb ibn Munabi, died 728, Ibn Ishaq, died 761, Al-Waqidi 745-822, Ibn Hisham, died 834, Al-Makrizi 1364-1442, and Ibn Hajar Asqalani 1372-1449, among others. Historiography, cultural history, and philosophy of history. Further information, Muqaddima and Ibn Khaldun. The first detailed studies on the subject of historiography itself and the first critiques on historical methods appeared in the works of the Arab Muslim historian and historiographer Ibn Khaldun 1332-1406, who is regarded as the father of historiography, cultural history, and the philosophy of history, especially for his historiographical writings in the Muqaddima, Latinized as Prolegomena, and Kitab al-Ibar, Book of Advice. His Muqaddima also laid the groundwork for the observation of the role of state, communication, propaganda, and systematic bias in history, and he discussed the rise and fall of civilizations. Franz Rosenthal wrote in The History of Muslim Historiography, "Muslim historiography has at all times been united by the closest ties with the general development of scholarship in Islam, and the position of historical knowledge in Muslim education has exercised a decisive influence upon the intellectual level of historici writing. The Muslims achieved a definite advance beyond previous historical writing in the sociology, sociological understanding of history, and the systematization of historiography. The development of modern historical writing seems to have gained considerably in speed and substance through the utilization of a Muslim literature, which enabled Western historians, from the 17th century on, to see a large section of the world through foreign eyes. The Muslim historiography helped indirectly and modestly to shape present-day historical thinking." In the Muqaddima, Ibn Khaldun warned of 7 mistakes that he thought that historians regularly committed in this criticism. He approached the past as strange and in need of interpretation. The originality of Ibn Khaldun was to claim that the cultural difference of another age must govern the evaluation of relevant historical material, to distinguish the principles according to which it might be possible to attempt the evaluation, and lastly, to feel the need for experience, in addition to rational principles, in order to assess a culture of the past. Ibn Khaldun often criticized idle superstition and uncritical acceptance of historical data. As a result, he introduced a scientific method to the study of history, which was considered something new to his age, and he often referred to it as his new science, now associated with historiography. His historical method also laid the groundwork for the observation of the role of state, communication, propaganda and systematic bias in history, and he is thus considered to be the father of historiography or the father of the philosophy of history. World History. Muhammad ibn Jarir al-Tabari 838-923 is known for writing a detailed and comprehensive chronicle of Mediterranean and Middle Eastern history in his History of the Prophets and Kings in 915. Abu al-Hasan Ali al-Masudi 896-956, known as the Herodotus of the Arabs, was the first to combine history and scientific geography in a large-scale work. Muraj adh Dahab wa Ma'adan al-Jawahir, The Meadows of Gold and Mines of Gems, a book on world history until the 10th century. History most often meant political and military history, but this was not so with Persian historian Biruni 973-1048 in his Kitab fi Taqiq ma Lil Hind Researches on India. He did not record political and military history in any detail, but wrote more on India's cultural, scientific, social and religious history along with his researches on India. Biruni discussed more on his idea of history in his chronological work The Chronology of the Ancient Nations. Famous Muslim historians. Further information, Muslim historians and list of Muslim historians. Urwa ibn Zubair died 712. Hadith of Umar's speech of forbidding Muta ibn Shihab al-Zuri died 742. Hadith of Umar's speech of forbidding Muta. Hadith of prohibition of Muta at Kaibar ibn Ishaq died 761. Sirah Rasul Allah Imam Malik died 796. Al-Mawada al-Waqidi 745-822. Book of History and Campaigns. Ali ibn al-Madini 777-850. The Book of Knowledge about the Companions. Ibn Hisham died 834. Sirah Rasul Allah Dhul Nun al-Misri died 859. Muhammad al-Bukhari 810-870. Sahih Bukhari. Muslim B. al-Hajjaj died 875. Sahih Muslim. Ibn Majah died 886. Sunan Ibn Majah. Abu Daud died 888. Sunan Abi Daud al-Tirmidhi died 892. Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Abu al-Hasan Ali al-Masudi 896-956. Muraj adh Dahab wa Ma'adan al-Jawahir, The Meadows of Gold and Mines of Gems 947. Ibn Washiya c. 904. Nabatine Agriculture. Kitab Shaq al-Mustaham al-Nasai died 915. Sunan al Sugra. Muhammad ibn Jarir al-Tabari 838-923. History of the Prophets and Kings. Tafsir al-Tabari al-Baladari died 892. Kitab Futu al-Buldan. Genealogies of the Nobles. Hakim al-Nishabari died 1014. Al-Mustadrak Allah al-Sahiyan. Abu Rayhan al-Biruni 973-1048. Indica. History of Mahmud of Ghazni and his father. History of Khawarizma. Abd al-Latif al-Baghdadi 13th century. Ibn Abi Zar died 1310-1320. Rad al-Kurtiz al-Dahabi 1274-1348. Major History of Islam. Takhiz al-Mustadrak. Tadkarat al-Hufiz al-Kamal Faima / Rifat al-Rijal. Ibn Khaldun 1332-1406. Mukaddimah 1377. Kitab al-Ibar. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani 1372-1449. Fath al-Bari. Tadib al-Tadib. Finding the Truth in Judging the Companions. Bulla al-Maram. Modern Academic Scholarship. The beginnings. The earliest academic scholarship on Islam arose in Western countries and tended to be Christian and Jewish translators and commentators. They translated the easily available Sunni texts from Arabic into European languages including German, Italian, French, or English, then summarized and commented in a fashion that was often hostile to Islam. Notable Christian scholars include William Muir 1819-1905, Reinhard Dozy 1820-1883, Die Israeliten zu Mecca 1864, David Samuel Margoluth 1858-1940, William Street, Claire Tisdall 1859-1928, Leonie Kaitani 1869-1935. Alphonse Mingana 1878-1937. All these scholars worked in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Another pioneer of Islamic studies, Abraham Geiger 1810-1874, was a prominent Jewish rabbi and approached Islam from that standpoint in his Was Hat Muhammad aus dem Judentum aufgenommen. What has Muhammad borrowed from Judaism? 1833 Geiger's themes were continued in Rabbi Abraham I. Katz's Judaism and the Quran 1962 Establishment of academic research. Other scholars, notably those in the German tradition, took a more neutral view. The late 19th century scholar Julius Wellhausen 1844-1918 is a prime example. They also started, cautiously, to question the truth of the Arabic texts. They took a source-critical approach, trying to sort the Islamic texts into elements to be accepted as historically true, and elements to be discarded as polemic or pious fiction. These scholars might include Michael Jan de Goje 1836-1909, Theodor Noldik 1836-1930, Ignaz Goldziher 1850-1921, Henri Lamans 1862-1937, Arthur Jeffery 1892-1959, H.A.R. Gibb 1895-1971. Joseph Schacht 1902-1969, Montgomery Watt 1909-2006. The Revisionist Challenge in the 1970s, the Revisionist School of Islamic Studies, or what has been described as a wave of skeptical scholars. Donner 1998 p. That the early history of Islam is a myth, generated after the conquests of Egypt, Syria, and Persia to prop up the new Arab regimes in those lands and give them a solid ideological foundation. According to their theory, the Quran was composed later, rather than early, and the Arab conquests may have been the cause, rather than the consequence, of Islam. The main evidence adduced for this thesis was based upon a contemporary body of non-Muslim sources to many early Islamic events. If such events could not be supported by outside evidence, then according to Crone and Cook they should be dismissed as myth. Crone and Cook's more recent work has involved intense scrutiny of early Islamic sources, but not their total rejection. See, for instance, Crone's 1987 publications, Roman, Provincial, and Islamic Law and Meccan Trade and the Rise of Islam, both of which assume the standard outline of early Islamic history while questioning certain aspects of it. Also Cook's 2001 Commanding Right and Forbidding Wrong in Islamic Thought, which also cites early Islamic sources as authoritative. In 1972, a cache of ancient Qurans in a mosque in Sana'a, Yemen was discovered, commonly known as the Sana'a manuscripts. The German scholar Gerd R. Puin has been investigating these Quran fragments for years. His research team made 35,000 microfilm photographs of the manuscripts, which he dated to early part of the 8th century. Puin has not published the entirety of his work, but noted unconventional verse orderings, minor textual variations, and rare styles of orthography. He also suggested that some of the parchments were palimpsests which had been reused. Puin believed that this implied an evolving text as opposed to a fixed one. Karl-Heinz Oleg researched as well Christian, Jewish roots of the Quran and its related texts. He sees the term Muhammad itself, the Blessed, as in Benedictus qui venit, as part of that tradition. Contemporary scholars have begun to turn to the study of the Islamic sources in a skeptical mood. They tend to use the histories rather than the hadith, and to analyze the histories in terms of the tribal and political affiliations of the narrators if that can be established, thus making it easier to guess in which direction the material might have been slanted. Notable scholars include Fred M. Donner, Wilford Madeling, Gerald Hodding, Jonathan Berkey, Andrew Rippon. Scholars combining traditional and academic scholarship. A few scholars have managed to bridge the divide between Islamic and Western-style secular scholarship. They have completed both Islamic and Western academic training. Sherman Jackson Fazlur, Rahman Suleiman Bashir. See also Islam Portal. Timeline of early Islamic history. Timeline of 7th century Muslim history. Timeline of 8th century Muslim history. List of biographies of Muhammad. Islamic conquests. References. Carat C. Sashadina 1981, pp. 54-55. Landolt 2005, p. 59. Madarasi 2003, pp. 82-88. Dekake 2007, p. 270. Carat http://horkalapuk/bibliography-hip/08a-shi-ism, imamologitum. Carat https://ustafsciencesoyanal/tilde-gent-0113/islam/islam_tabcalhtm. Carat http://discdiscovery.com/news/2008/11/18/islamic-inscriptionmail. Carat http://uislamic-awareness.org/history/islam/inscriptions/kufixodmal. Carat Ahmad, IA June 3, 2002. Faith and Reason, Convergence and Complementarity. PDF Al-Aqawain University. Retrieved 7 May 2011. Carat Enan, Muhammad Abdullah 2007. Ibn Khaldun, His Life and Works. The Other Press. P. Darwin Press, 1998. Hoyland, Robert G. Seeing Islam as Others Saw It, A Survey and Evaluation of Christian, Jewish and Zoroastrian Writings on Early Islam, Darwin Press, 1997. Madeling, Wilford, 1997. The Succession to Muhammad, A Study of the Early Caliphate, Cambridge University Press. ISBN Historiography. Historians. Primary sources. Historical documents. Papyri. Religious texts. Codices. Scrolls. Hieroglyphs. Manuscripts. Facsimiles. Archives. Deeds. Organizations. Institutes. Historical Society. Historiographical Institute of the University of Tokyo. Concepts. Choice. Translatio imperi. Renaissance. Battle for Australia. Pax Sinica. Methodology. Schools. Choice. Analyse. School. History of Mentalities. Nouvelle Histoire. Microhistory. Case Study. Historical Linguistics. Great Man Theory. Heroic Theory of Invention and Scientific Development. Historic Recurrence. Historical Anthropology. Historical Determinism. Historical Realism. Historicism. Historiometry. Cliometrics. Historism. Marxist. Historiography. Historical Materialism. Codicology. Paleography. Intellectual History. Idea of Progress. History of Modernization Theory. Historical Criticism. Historical Geography. Historical Geographic Information System by Country. Historiography of Albania. Historiography of Argentina. Historiography of Canada. Chinese Historiography. Historiography of Germany. Greek Historiography. Historiography of Early Islam. Historiography of Japan. Roman Historiography. Serbian Historiography. Encyclopedia of Serbian Historiography. Historiography in the Soviet Union. Historiography of the United Kingdom. Historiography of the United States. Historiography of Scotland. Historiography of Switzerland. Others. Historiography of Science. Historiography of the Salon. Historiography of the May Revolution. Historiography of World War II. Functionalism versus Intentionalism. Historiography of Early Islam. Related. Historical Fiction. Historical Revisionism. Historical Negationism. Historiography and Nationalism. Historical Marker. List of Historians. V.E. Islamic Studies. Arts. Arabesque. Architecture. Calligraphy. The Garden. Geometric Pattern. Literature. Music. Poetry. Pottery. Influences on Western Art. Economics. History. Agency. Banking. Capitalism. Poverty. Socialism. Trust. Usury. Welfare. History. Timeline. Historiography. Early Social Change. Conquests. Golden Age. Contributions to Medieval Europe. Reception in Early Modern Europe. Law. Politics. Anarchism. Democracy. Consensus. Consultation. Feminism. Jurisprudence. Use of analogy. Decision making. Schools. Peace. Quietism. Secularism. Early Social Change. State Philosophy. Early Contemporary Theology. Dialectic. Ethics. Logic. Metaphysics. Astrology. Early Sociology. Solidarity. Medieval Science. Timeline. Alchemy and Chemistry. Astronomy. Cosmology. Geography and Cartography. Inventions. Mathematics. Medicine. Ophthalmology. Physics. Psychology. Other fields. Arab. Agricultural Revolution. Education. Teaching. Permission. Elementary School. Sufi studies. Mysticism. Cosmology. Philosophy.